Namaste and a very happy International Day of Yoga. With the launch of the SRMD Yoga Teachers Training Course, we're extremely elated to share this practice all over the world. And of course, the main practice being the core essence of yoga and connecting to that. So that is today's theme, which is to connect to the core essence of yoga. We'll be doing 30 minutes of asana practice, followed by a special sound bath by Atmarpit Angiben, who has done a special module in the teacher's training course on sound healing. So let's get started with today's practice. Simply connect to yourself, enjoy the practice, and connect back to your essence. So let's start from a standing position, rolling our shoulders back nice and steady. If at any point of time you feel any discomfort, don't worry, just pause and join. And then rotate the direction the other way. And gently bring your hands into Namaskara Mudra in front of your lower chest. As we connect, closing our eyes, beginning with our prayer as we chant Om, followed by the prayer. Inhale. Take a moment here to yourself, grounding yourself, centering yourself. Connect to your breath. And as you inhale, gently open your eyes, interlock your hands in front of your chest, and inhale, raise them up above your head. Feel the stretch. As you exhale, release the arms besides you, forward fold, and try to touch the floor nice and gentle. As we inhale, raise the hands up besides you one more time. Interlock them ahead of you and stretch above. As you exhale, forward fold, come down, touch the floor. We're gonna do this three more times. As you inhale, raise the hands up, feel the stretch. And exhale, touch the floor. Keep going. Inhale, raise it up. Stretch it up. And exhale. Last one. You can do it. Inhale, feel that stretch. Lift yourself up as high as you can. And exhale, touch the floor, spreading your feet apart slightly. Take a little bit of distance, interlock your hands behind your back, and relax in Uttanasana variation. Just relax, try to straighten your legs, make sure they're nice and straight. Perfect. Keep breathing, go deeper. Lovely. Try to straighten your back from here and go deeper. The goal is to touch the forehead to the knee. Lovely. As you exhale and simply allow your right hand to meet the left ankle and twist to the left side. Feel the stretch in your spine, a beautiful spinal twist. Fantastic. Open up as deep as you can. Keep breathing. For five more counts, one, lovely, two, three, keep breathing, feel your energies, four, and five, fantastic, rolling over to the other side, five more counts here, keep breathing. Try to really twist as deeply as you can. This is extremely good for whoever has any back problems here. One, two, lovely. Three, four, and five. Coming back to center, both the hands below the feet into Padahastasana. In case this is too challenging, simply place your hands on the ankles. There is no problem. At your own pace for five counts here. One, two, three, four, and five. Fantastic. Gently placing both your hands behind your lower back. Inhale, raise yourself up nice and gentle, going into a standing chakrasana. Give yourself a nice back bend here. Look up, try to straighten both the legs. Feel the stretch. Lovely. Five more counts. Try to go deeper. One, two, fantastic. Three, keep breathing. Four, and five. Coming back to center and releasing yourselves into Gati Chakrasana. 10 counts here, five on each side. One, enjoy your practice. Two, three, lovely. Four, and five. Gliding into Vrikshasana. So gently placing your right foot in. In case this is too challenging, you can simply keep your leg on the floor, touching the ankle. Whatever you're comfortable with, lovely. And then as you're comfortable, inhale, raise the hands up above your head into Namaskara Mudra. Balance yourself here for five counts, feeling rooted, coming back to the essence of yoga. Rooted like a firm tree, grounded with strong roots. One, two, three, fantastic. Four, and five. Gently release your posture and repeat on the other side. Taking your other leg, left leg, fantastic. Balance yourself here for a few moments. And then as you're comfortable, raise the hands up. Balance yourself, look ahead of you. That's gonna really help you to really focus. Relax the shoulders. Lovely. Both hands in Namaskara, nicely placed together, palms together. One, two, three, lovely. Four, and beautiful smiles. Five, and release. Come back to center. Here, take a moment, close your eyes. Samasthitihi, connect back to yourself. The goal of yoga is not just to be flexible physically, but it's to be flexible inwards. So inner flexibility. So check in with yourself. Take this practice to really make it a meditative experience for yourself. And as you're comfortable, gently opening your eyes. And let's spread our feet apart by 3 to 4 feet distance with the right leg into 90 and left leg in 40 degrees. Getting ready for the practice of Trikonasana, the Trinity. So inhale, raise the hands up parallel to the floor. As you exhale, extend as much as you can and then drop down. Either placing your hand on the floor or you can simply place it on your foot or the ankle, whatever you're comfortable with. This is showing and representing the alignment of the body, mind, and soul. So connecting back to that message. For five counts, open up your shoulders, open up your chest. One, two, keep breathing. Three, lovely. Four, and five. From here, gently flowing into warrior two. Bend the knees as much as you can here, making a nice 90 degree angle, feeling that courage, that spirit of strength within you. You're a peaceful warrior. So let's stay here, lovely, for five counts. A little deeper, one, fantastic, two, three, four, and five. Let's do it dynamically now. So allowing both the hands to come up, warrior one, and then coming into warrior two. Try to really keep those knees bent. Warrior one, warrior two. Three more times. One, come back to center. Lovely. Two, back to center. And three. That's beautiful. Inhale, come back and switch sides. For Trikona Asana, prepare yourself, feel your breath. Getting ready as you extend. Extend as much as you can. Don't drop down directly. And then once you're ready, placing your hand either on the floor, the ankle, or your foot. Open up the chest. Relax the shoulders. Square the hips. Lovely. Five counts. One, keep breathing. Remember the trinity of body, mind, and soul. Two, three, connecting back to the essence. Four, and five, flowing into warrior two. Bending the knee as much as you can. Lovely. Feeling that peaceful warrior within yourself. You have the power. Lovely. One, a little deeper. Two, three, four, a little deeper. Fantastic. And five, dynamically done with the hands coming up into warrior one. And exhale. We'll do five together. That's one. Inhale up. Two. Exhale down. Three. Inhale up. Exhale down. Four. Keep going. Last one. And five. Inhale up. And exhale. Lovely. Come back to center. Allow yourself to keep that distance between both the feet. Parallel to each other. And then gently place your hands behind your back. Inhale into a beautiful back bend. And then exhale, forward fold. Halfway through, we're not going fully here. So simply place your hands on the floor. And let's stay here for five counts. Feel the stretch in your lower legs. One, two, three, four, and five. Allowing the right hand to stay rooted on the floor. And open up to your left side. Raise the hand up. Twist as much as you can. Fantastic. One, two, three, four, and five. Let's do the same on the other side for a beautiful twist. One, two, fantastic. Three, four, and five. Coming back to center and gently placing your feet slightly closer together. So allow them to walk towards each other. And then gently placing your hands again behind your back. Interlock them together into a relaxed Uttanasana. Feel the difference now. The first time you did it and now the second time that you're doing it. Can you feel a difference in your body? Can you feel yourself be more flexible outside and within you? Check. Come back to the core, to the essence of your practice. Five counts. One, two, fantastic. Three, four, and five. Gently raise yourself up and relax. Samasthiti. Close your eyes one more time. Let's come back. Focus on your breath. Allow this experience to be meditative. Watch your body. Watch your breath. How are you feeling? What are you feeling? Take a moment to connect. And then whenever you are comfortable, gently open your eyes. Lovely, with a lovely smile. Coming to the top of your mat. Getting ready to come to Adho So you're going to raise your hands up, Urdhva. Exhale, Uttanasana. And then step back into Ardha Mukha Svanasana. Lovely. If you're feeling tight, you can do the dancing dog. Release your hamstrings. Push the shoulders in. Fantastic. Stay here 10 counts. 1, 2, 3. Lovely. Feet parallel to each other. Try to touch the heels to the floor. Perfect. Try to really have the feet parallel to each other. 5. Push the shoulders in. A little bit more distance between your feet. 6. Fantastic. 7. 8. Lovely. Everyone's doing great. 9. And 10. Flowing into Urdhva Mukha Svanasana from where you are. Drop down. Relax the shoulders. Open up your chest. Lovely. Try to point the feet back if you can, and then raise the knees up into Urdhva. Or if you want to keep it simple, you can also keep it as Bhujangasana, whatever you feel comfortable today. 1, 2, relax the shoulders. 3, look up. 4, lovely. 5, point the toes back. 6, 7, fantastic. 8, 9, and 10. And then relaxing in Ardha Mukha Balasana. Just open up your knees here as wide as you can. Feel the stretch in your hips. Your lower back is going to get released as well. Just relax. Fantastic. 5 counts here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Gently inhale, raise yourself up, and then placing your hands behind your back, we're going to do the moon breathing. So you're going to inhale, open up your chest, look up, and as you exhale, forward fold, surrender yourself completely. Touch the forehead to the floor. As you inhale, again, lift yourself up. Open up your heart here. And exhale, forward fold, touch the floor. Inhale, raise yourself out. That's 3. We're doing 5 together. And exhale, down. Surrender yourself completely. Inhale, open up your heart. Lovely. And exhale, forward fold. Last one. Inhale, raise yourself up, and exhale, forward fold, and then gently come back to center, allowing yourself to come into an elephant stretch. So your hands are going to come into elephant. Feel your shoulders opening here for 5 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Open up, skater hands. 5 together. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Switching over to the other side. Elephant hands. 5 more counts. Feel that opening. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lovely. And 5. Fantastic. Release for some cat and cow movements here. So you're going to just inhale, curve your back. And as you exhale, round your back. A little bit of a massage for your spine. That's 2. Exhale down. 3. Open up, curve your back. Feel that spine. 4. Open up. Last one. And 5. Coming back to center and allowing your right leg to come up into a 90 almost. And then as you're comfortable, placing your right hand on your right foot and open up to the left side into a twist. If this is too difficult, you can also do this in a seated position. So from Sukhasana, whatever you are comfortable with. 5 counts here. 1, 2, try to hold your big toe. 3, and then twist as much as you can. 4, And five. Now we're going to twist the other way around. So left hand comes on the floor, touches the right foot, and open up to the right side. Try to place your entire elbow on the floor. You're going to feel a deeper stretch this time. It's going to really feel good in your back. One, two, three. This pose reminds us that we're very small, so allowing ourselves to remain humble on the path. And five, come back to center, and then gently release the right leg towards the side. Keep the left leg as it is. And then gently placing the left hand on the floor and raise yourself up into mandala asana. Feel the stretch in your shoulders. Fantastic. Try to point your toe. Lovely. One, two, three, four, and five. Drop down and gently surrender yourself into a forward fold, trying to touch your forehead to your knee. Feel the stretch in your lower body. That experience of surrendership here. Try to breathe. Go deeper. As you inhale and breathe out, go deeper every time. Check in with your back. Is it straight? Lovely. One, two, a little deeper. Three, straighten your back. Four, and five. Fantastic. Inhale, raise yourself up. As you exhale, release the right leg. And then we're going to do the same sequence with the left side. So beginning with our gentle twist, holding your big toe and opening up to the right side. Feel the stretch in your spine. A beautiful spinal twist. One, two, three, fantastic. Four, a little more. And five, lovely. Flowing to the other side, allowing your entire elbow to meet the floor. Remembering that we are humble, we are nothing. Feeling that feeling of humility. Lovely. One, two, three, four, and five. Straighten out your leg as you're comfortable. And we're going to flow into mandala asana. Lift yourself up into your flower pose. Lovely. One, two, look back. Three, fantastic. Four, and five, forward fold. So drop down. And now take your time. We are not in any rush. Try to really flow. Go deeper. Try to allow your forehead to meet your knee. Lovely. Take your time. Connect back to the essence. One, two, lovely. Three, four, and five. Fantastic. Coming back up and making your way into a comfortable prone position onto your bellies. And for a moment here, let's just relax in Makarasana, allowing your feet to dance. A little bit of smiles. Just enjoy your practice. One, two, three, four, and five. So today we're going to do the baby cobra, the intermediate cobra, and the king cobra. So baby cobra, allowing your toes to meet. Your hands are by the chest. Elbows are tucked in. Now baby cobra, just lift your chest up. That's it. Intermediate cobra, lift yourself a little higher. And then straighten out completely. Look up into your king. Back to baby. Nice and gentle. We're not in any rush. Intermediate. And king. Keep going. Baby. Toes together. Intermediate. And king. Relax the shoulders. Baby. Feet together. Intermediate. King. Lovely. Intermediate. King. Baby. King. baby, king. Baby, king, last one, intermediate, king, and stay in your king for five counts. One, fantastic, feel your lower back. Two, three, open up the chest, relax the shoulders. Four, and five, nicely drop down back into Makarasana. And just relax, allow yourself to dance here with your feet. Five counts. One, two, three, four, and five. Allowing both the ankles to meet your hands and lift yourself up. Now your body is ready now. Into your Dhanurasana, bow pose. And try to really roll yourself from front to back. Lovely. Feel the chest opening. One, two, a little higher. Three, fantastic. Everyone's doing fantastic. Four, beautiful. And five, release. Makarasana, just relax. One, two, three, four, and five. Make your way onto a supine position, your face facing Bhagwan. As we come on to our last series of asanas for today's practice. So make yourself comfortable in Pavan Muktasana. Give yourself a hug, a warm hug. This again reminds us to come back to the message of loving ourselves. So come into Pavan Muktasana, giving yourself that love. Beautiful. Five counts here. One. If you want to challenge yourself, you can touch your forehead to your knees. Two, three, four, and five. Release the legs onto the floor for Setu Bandhasana. So gently lifting your waist up. We're going to do it five times together. One. You can hold your ankles. Two, three, four, up and down, and five. And as you're comfortable, release into Supta Baddha Konasana. Relax completely, supine butterfly pose. Fantastic. Feel that release. Allow gravity to do its own work here. And just relax, let go completely. Feel the energy flowing in your body. Feel the difference in your body. Check in with yourself, coming back to the core essence. And once you're comfortable, extend your legs into our final posture, Shavasana or Chansarovara Asana for whoever has any back problems. So Chansarovara Asana is with your knees bent, a little bit of distance between both the feet. And in Shavasana, your feet are going to be at the distance of your mat. Palms facing upwards to receive the higher energy. And just relax. Let go completely and surrender. Feel your breath. Tune into yourself. Staying where you are, today we're extremely blessed to be together celebrating International Day of Yoga. So let's end our practice with a beautiful 15 minutes sound bath meditation. You can stay in Shavasana, allow yourself to tune into higher frequencies, taking this practice at a deeper level. Let's get started.
Take a deep breath in and breathe out. Let go of any distracting thoughts. Release the tension in the body and just relax. Feel comfortable in the position that you have chosen today. And let us begin with the sound bath. Simply let the sounds and the resonance guide you through this session. Vibrations, relax the body completely. Thank you. Let us now experience the frequency of harmony and peace. 432. Experience yourself as the ocean of compassion. And just relax completely. Slowly come back to your surroundings. Gently raise your arms above your head. And turn to your right side. Just relax here for a few moments. And whenever you feel ready, you may come to a seated position, keeping the eyes closed. Bringing our hands in Namaskar Mudra at the heart center, let's end with the closing prayer.
Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukha bhag bhavet. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. Let us bow down in gratitude and pray for world peace, safety, and happiness, gently rubbing our hands together to create heat and massaging your face in the upward direction. And whenever you feel ready, you may gently open your eyes. Namaste.